It's BRStv Reef FAQ Wednesday, and today we answer, how do I program spectrum? Is it time to start flipping switches? Hey, I'm Ryan with BRStv Reef FAQs, a resource for quick, straight to the point answers and realizing that dream reef tank. It's time to answer how to program your LED lights, meaning intensity, photo period, spectrum, and ramp time. This week, we're taking on just the spectrum portion of that question, but more importantly, how do you know when you got it right? This will be a bit more in depth than your average fact, but anyone looking to solve the challenges, or more directly put, solve the lighting-related mortalities that they've been experiencing, or just enjoys the path of system design perfection, this is it. With 90% or more reefers using LEDs, the days of plug-and-play simplicity with halides and T5s and the no-brainer approach to spectrum are long gone. The LEDs now give us the keys to the spectrum and intensity kingdom, but sadly, with few exceptions, most of the manufacturers out there didn't bother to tell us how to drive when they handed us those keys. Most provide almost no information on how to adjust the spectrum or intensity to support the metabolic function of the animals that we care for. Because of that, many people just adjust to what looks good to the eye and hope for the best. All these sliders are essentially the same as allowing the average driver to adjust the car's computer for custom air-gas mixtures without any real guidance on what that's going to do, or at least this is a super advanced feature that should only be used by the pros. More or less, all this amounts to the slide-and-play approach. Some reefers will get lucky, some are just intuitive guessers, but many obviously fail. Fail meaning mortalities, slow growth, and undesirable coloration. Our goal here is the highest percentage path to success possible, so we're going to share our unique solution to find that in relation to spectrum. Luckily, you don't need to be a marine biologist or get this absolutely perfect to have a successful reef tank. The most important factor here is stability. Corals are amazingly adaptive creatures if you just give them a chance. That primarily means resisting the temptation to flip the switches. If there's one thing that you take away from this entire video, let it be, set the spectrum to the best of your ability and then leave it alone for 9 to 12 months, if not permanently. If you're flipping switches every week, month, or even every few months, don't be surprised if it shows in negative results. That's another reason why T5 and halide bulbs produce those plug-and-play results, not because every bulb had the perfect spectrum, but the nature of the bulb is you only change them out every 12 to 18 months. Stability is king. So what are the best spectrum settings for our reefs and how do we implement them? Meaning all those UV, violet, deep blue, blue, light blue, green, red, and now even infrared channels. What are you supposed to do with them all? Again, they're not actually color channels that we can flip to whatever we like and expect the corals to thrive. The channels are essentially beams of energy, and the corals have adapted over millennia to specific spectrum ranges, meaning they can use specific wavelength peaks much more efficiently than others, and some spectrums can actually cause major metabolic differences, like drastic color changes. This chart from Orphic is a good example of the spectrum peaks many of the coral types utilize and the areas the corals can potentially utilize the most efficiently. You can see the color of the light on the bar below and how that references different nanometers or wavelengths of light. Then above that, you can see where the various types of chlorophyll and carotenoids are the most efficient at absorbing those energy wavelengths, which our eyes see as color. Well, all those LED channels have very specific peaks that blended together create the desired spectrum mix. For instance, here's our measurements of all the different spectrum peaks of the AI prime channels, and then what the spectrum mix looks like when they're all blended together to make that one cohesive spectrum mix, like the AB custom mix that we made for the AI prime. How well each light is able to do this is up to some debate, but you can certainly see those that are making a strong attempt because they tell you what they're doing and why they do it. For instance, here's another graph that measures the spectrum offering that the Orphic produces and how it overlays with the light of energy requirements of many of the corals. Okay, how in the world is a reefer supposed to do this at home? Because I can guarantee almost none of you own a multi-$1,000 spectrometer to measure spectrum and blend all those spectrums perfectly. There has to be a better way than slide and pray. Well, by far the best way to do that is expect the manufacturer of the light you bought to do that for you. I think most reefers just want to set the light to coral health setting and plug it in. The light is in fact designed to support coral health, so it's not too much to ask from the people that are selling it for that purpose. If the pro level reefers want to do the research, adjust the sliders from there, that's awesome, but it should probably be hidden in some pro tab, which might be properly referenced as death or brown town mode if the switches are treated like a toy and flipped frequently. Some of the companies who've done that the best over the years are Kessel, with the peaks important to metabolic health locked down, but the less critical peaks adjustable for visual appeal, something they call Kessel Logic. Ecotech's Coral Labs and AB Plus Spectrum Mix, based on research and results in high demand environments like coral grow out facilities, where maximizing growth and coloration is what makes them profitable. Red Sea's new Reef Spec, which has lockdown options based on their research, is another example. In these cases, in any other case where the light manufacturer directly suggests this is the right mix for a reef tank, or even further refines it to SPS or LPS mode, I trust their expertise and use their spectrum settings. Optimized settings designed for the goal is part of what you get when you pick the right light. If you don't trust their expertise, I think it might be wise to consider another option rather than try to fix their lack of expertise yourself. It's likely the manufacturer's lack of understanding or effort to the light's intended use is going to show itself in a variety of ways. Get the right tool for the right job and you'll be happy with the results it produces. So there are many options out there that only provide slider bars and limited advice on how to use them. To be frank, the options which don't put a lot of money into R&D are often lower cost, which obviously is attractive for those that are willing to put a bit more effort in to achieve the same results. There's no universal right answer here, but there are a few paths. First, as part of BRStv Investigates episodes on the individual lights, we generally recommend a specific spectrum mix, often based on using a spectrometer to measure and adjust a light to emulate the most successful spectrum mixes in the hobby. Certainly a good resource on the spectrum an LED light is capable of producing, and then how to mix them to achieve the desired goal. Outside of that, if there are limited resources available on the light that you selected, most people will have to make their best guess. As a general statement on well-designed lights with proper LED spectrum ratios, this may be helpful, but it doesn't apply to every last light. The most beneficial wavelengths tend to be what the eye perceives as the blue spectrums. For that reason, most reefers will turn those UV, violet, blue spectrums to max, then add white in until it looks appealing. Most reefers will then use the red and green sparingly because the reefing community is undecided on their value. There's a lot of discussion on the value of red in particular. Red and green also tend to really highlight the disco ball effect because those individual colors are easy to see shooting all around the tank. Once you get this adjusted, you'll likely have to take the second step of adjusting them all down in ratio to each other to get the desired par or intensity. Some options like the Radeon and Kessel have intensity sliders which adjust the intensity or ratio of all the channels together, but a majority require you to do it individually. We'll get into the intensity next week, but renting a par meter is the best bet. However, rather than just sliding all the blues up, are there better paths? If you don't know what's best, ask. Almost any question on Reef to Reef or our Facebook group, hashtag AskBRStv community, is answered by multiple people within minutes. Because things like Facebook groups are attached to your phone, it's easy and can often get a dozen responses inside of 10 minutes. Most of the community is also willing to show you their actual results associated with the exact light you're using and their settings. It's my personal opinion that the best results are from emulating those who come before you. The next bit on this is something called spectrum blending. That means our T5 and halide bulbs offered a uniform spectrum, but LEDs need a slew of different LED peaks to emulate that. Visually, it may look blended, but if you look closely at the tank, you can often see individual dots or lines of white, blue, green, and red shooting all around the tank, and that's what the hobby refers to as spectrum hotspots or poorly blended spectrum. Much of this is created by the ripples on the surface of the water, catching the individual LED spectrums, magnifying it, and shooting it all around the tank. I think the jury's still out on how much this matters, but I can say with near 100% confidence, almost everyone would prefer a uniform, perfectly blended spectrum if they had the choice. Outside that, a well-blended spectrum not only is almost certainly better metabolically for the coral, but also looks a ton better visually. Properly blending the spectrum eliminates the little green, red, and blue dots shooting all around the tank and the most unpleasant of disco ball effects. There are three common solutions to that currently. First is Kessel's approach of putting all the LEDs under a single lens does a really good job of blending all the individual spectrums together, something that we tested in air and underwater in BRStv Investigates. Also, the diffused options, which use a sheet diffuser material to blend the spectrums, the most common in the US being Ecotech's Radeon's optional diffuser. This does reduce the light output a bit, but comes with performance advantages. I don't think most people buy high-end lights like this for maximum par alone, but really maximum performance on a variety of fronts. This is again something you can see definitively in the Diffuser Investigates episode. Third, you can pair your LEDs with T5's even spectrum, which will mute the spectrum hotspots, something you can see both visually as well as likely metabolically. Another question here is, should the spectrum change throughout the day, such as bluer in the morning or evening? I can say, well, I don't think anyone knows the answer to this definitively. We do know that changing spectrum is not required for success. If you do want to change the spectrum for visual appeal, I consider doing it similar to the way Kessel Logic does it, which is reduce the whites but leave all the blues the same. Then remember, stability is more important than anything that we've said today. Set it, let the corals adapt, and achieve the desired results. I will say the WWC does change their spectrum throughout the day from wider to bluer with very minimal ramp times. Metallity is somewhat turbocharged photosynthesis in the morning and then give them a break throughout the rest of the day. I think anyone considering either new lighting or optimizing their current lighting would benefit from watching that lighting episode of the hybrid series. It's almost certain that you'll take away something that benefits your tank. See you next Wednesday with the next batch of BRStv Reef FAQs.